This is a teaching video for the two-step blood pressure measurement technique. When we first teach learners how to take blood pressure, we begin with the two-step technique, and as they become more proficient, they can advance to the one-step technique. So to begin with, I'm going to ask you to put your arm up on the table with your hand up like that. I also would like you to have your back flat against the back of the chair and your feet flat on the floor. Good. It's also going to involve a little bit of touching. Is that okay? Just on your arm. Okay. So to start with, I'm going to palpate the brachial pulse. So I begin by feeling the biceps tendon at the antecubital fossa. I'm going to move medial to the biceps tendon and 2.5 centimeters above. And I'm going to feel a fair amount of pressure to feel for your brachial pulse. I've quickly located her brachial pulse so I know where her artery is. And I want to apply the cuff's artery line right on top of that artery. So I've applied the cuff so that it's fit fairly snugly. I can put one finger inside so that the cuff won't move around. It's also straight and aligned on her arm. Next, I'm going to determine maximum pressure inflation. So this is the number that I need to inflate the cuff to when I go to take blood pressure. In order to determine maximum pressure inflation, you can palpate either the brachial pulse or the radial pulse. I'm going to palpate the radial pulse. So I'm going to close the valve and I'm going to inflate my cuff fairly quickly until I can no longer feel the pulse. So I obliterated the pulse at 100. I'm going to continue 30 millimeters of mercury beyond that to ensure that it's obliterated, which it is at 130, and then I quickly deflate the cuff. So your maximum pressure inflation number is 130 millimeters of mercury. That's going to be the number that I'm going to pump up the cuff to when I take blood pressure. Now we're ready to take blood pressure. So your arm's just going to reperfuse there for about 15 seconds while I cleanse the stethoscope. And then we're ready to take blood pressure. So when we go to take blood pressure, I'm going to place the cleansed end of my bell over your brachial artery. When I do this, blood flow is unobstructed at this point, so I won't hear anything. Blood flow is silent. And then I'm going to inflate the cuff to your maximum pressure inflation, which is 130 millimeters of mercury. I'm going to slowly open that valve about 2 to 3 millimeters of mercury per second. And as the needle comes down, the very first carotid cough sound is systolic blood pressure. Those sounds will continue to change in quality, and they'll become muffled, and then they go silent. The very last carotid cough sound is diastolic blood pressure. So I'm going to inflate the cuffs. You're going to feel a little bit of pressure on your arm now. I'm going to close the valve. Inflate the cuff to 130 millimeters of mercury. And then slowly deflate. Noting the systolic. And noting the diastolic. And then I quickly deflate. So your blood pressure was 112 over 62, which is within the normal range. I would also normally take a pulse whenever I take a blood pressure. So that's a demonstration of the two-step blood pressure measurement technique. Now you can try it out yourself.